Christmas tree at the Christmas party hop.
Good morning, CB. It's Tuesday, December 8th.
I'm Kimmy.
And I'm John.
And here are your morning announcements. Our second Spirit Week is coming up on December 14th to 18th. These are the following days and themes. There will also be a Grade Battle Cahoot Tournament Wednesday at 3, where the 9s will battle the 10s and the 11s the 12s. Thursday at 3 will be the Championship Game and the Consolation Final.
Congratulations to everyone who played in last Friday's Fun Friday Kahoot game. The top three were, in first place, Aaron Reyes from grade 12, second, Brian Lin from grade 10, and in third place, Sam Liu from grade 12.
Colonel Bai has a strong reputation of giving to our community throughout the school year. We thank you for all your efforts which made our virtual fall food drive a success this past fall.
We will be collecting donations through School Cash Online this December so we can come together and fix a holiday hamper for a community family that's in need.
All donations raised will be split three ways: the Shepherds of Good Hope, who provide amazing help to vulnerable families; the Gloucester Emergency Food Cupboard, who prepares holiday baskets for patrons accessing their services; and for our own school, where we'll be preparing holiday hampers for CV families in need.
The program will run from Monday, December 7th to Wednesday, December 16th. Let's show the community that we can still share our holiday spirit and cheer and hope for a better 2021.
National Day of Remembrance and Action on Violence Against Women took place on December 6th. Please visit CV's Feminism Club campaign on Instagram that will be running from December 7th to 11th. They would like to invite students to join them for a discussion during the club meeting on Saturday, December 12th at noon.
That's all from us today, CB. Now, here's your sports desk.
What's up, sports fans? I'm Griffin.
And I'm Alexia.
And this is your sports desk.
Hey, Alexia, do you know what you want to do for post-secondary school?
No, but I've been looking into a career in kinesiology.
Oh, really? Why don't we go check out a physiotherapy clinic in Colonel Bai's very own neighborhood to get a better look into that?
Okay, let's go.
Thanks, guys. I'm here at Performance Sports Therapy to check out how they've been impacted by COVID-19 and see what the sports therapy field is like for post-secondary students. Let's go check it out. I'm here with
Dr. Anthony Aiello,
clinic owner and sports chiropractor at Performance Sports Therapy. So Anthony, can you briefly describe the services you offer here at Performance Sports Therapy?
Yeah, so we operate a multidisciplinary sports medicine clinic consisting of physiotherapists, chiropractors, registered massage therapists, personal trainers, mental health consultants, and we have medical doctors on site as well.
Has there been a decline in students and student-athletes coming to the clinic given the fact that COVID-19 has no sports running?
I think there's definitely been a decline overall. Definitely not the same injury rates that we've seen in the past and that we're used to. They are still practicing and you know, with that there's always going to be injuries occurring. So we are still seeing some, and oftentimes what can happen too is when you're not in your usual routine, you're going to get injuries from not playing your sport or practicing as much just from being a little bit sedentary. So we're still seeing some of the athletes, but definitely the numbers are down from what they usually are.
All right, perfect. Thank you so much. I'm here with
Andre Doucette,
a second-year physiotherapy school student. So Andre, would you recommend to high school students to pursue a career as a physiotherapist or sports chiropractor?
Absolutely. As for physiotherapy and chiropractor, I'd absolutely recommend it if you want to go in the healthcare profession. If you really like a hands-on job and you also want to get involved in helping people, helping the quality of life, and yeah, absolutely.
Right, perfect, thank you. And as a physiotherapy school student, what is your role around here at Performance Sports Therapy?
So as for here, this is a 5-week placement. The first week was mostly just observation, getting the feel around here. I follow James, the physiotherapist here. And now during my second week, I'm doing mostly like I'm interviewing the patients, writing down what the problems are on the charts, doing all the charting, doing some objective measures, see how they're doing, the range of motion, all the muscular strengths and everything. And then I get sometimes involved in treatment as well, just like physiotherapist will show me his technique because it's slightly different than what we've learned in school. He shows me it and I'll apply it.
All right, great. Thank you so much. I'm here with
Kyla Bruni,
a fourth year human kinetics student at UOttawa. So Kyla, would you recommend to high school students to pursue a career as a physiotherapist or sports chiropractor?
I would definitely recommend it as a career if you want to help people, if you enjoy helping people and, you know, watching people overcome injuries and having a meaningful impact on people's lives.
So, okay, yeah. Perfect, thank you. So what kind of post-secondary education and schooling is needed to get into the field?
So normally you need a four-year bachelor degree. So I'm in human kinetics, which is a pretty popular choice. You can also do any health science or pretty much any undergrad. And then I think that it would be really beneficial to get your foot in the door and kind of volunteer or, you know, have internship experiences where you can experience what is actually happening and what's going on, and usually around a 2 or 3 year post-secondary physio school.
All right, perfect. Thank you so much. Thank you to Performance Sport Therapy for having us and giving us some insight as to what a career in kinesiology can look like for post-secondary students. Back to you guys.
Wow, a career in human kinetics does seem really interesting.
Yeah. Thank you to Performance Sport Therapy for having us.
This week, we want to give a special shout-out to a Cougar athlete who excelled even in these tough times.
Congratulations to Jerry DeLorme on his recent commitment to the University of Ottawa football team.
We look forward to seeing you in Garnet and Gray.
Well, that's all from us today, CB.
Stay safe and stay healthy.
To Cohort A at home.
And Cohort B in school.
I'm Griffin.
And I'm Alexia.
And we're your sports desk.
Signing off.